You have only three things in your hand: the thoughts, the way you think, the second is the image you visualize, and third is the action you take. You must have heard of the thing inverse paranoia, or you must have heard of the thing blessing in disguise. Blessing is disguise is when you think about the possibilities of what opportunity lies in my this particular problem, or when you are habituated to think good about everything, you actually think about good about particular problems in your life also. And when you think good about what good I have or having this particular problem, then you find new possibilities and then you set your way to success. For example, yesterday I told you about Lisa Ryan, that when she was enjoying her job, she was HR of a big company, but when recession occurred, she got frustrated by the calls from the customer, and eventually she had made her mind to leave the job. And when she decided to leave the job, she was actually feeling like what great lies in leaving this particular job. So she found out her goal list, and in her goal list, whatever was written, that she wanted to become an expertise professional motivational speaker. So she worked for it in the next year, and she completely changed or turned her life 360 degrees, and she is a motivational speaker now. So Jack can feel the author of Chicken Soup for Your Soul and the expertise speaker in the movie The Secret mentions that he had a job at Corpus Center in Clinton. He was pioneering new ways to teach underachieving students. So the center was being relocated, so he lost his job. At that time he attended a workshop, and he also was finding what great lies in this particular disguise of mine. So what blessing lies in this particular disguise? So at that time he said that I am getting time for writing a book I always wanted to write. I wanted to be a very good speaker. With a bigger salary and a lab for learning different success principle, he completely transformed his life. He generated a new career path for him from this blessing in disguise. Similarly, Mahatma Gandhi, when he was traveling to London and he was thrown out of the train, so because being a Indian, because of being a black person, so he got so much insulted and mortified from inside that he decided to make India free, so that the people in India can develop themselves and grow so well that everybody will respect Indians. Similarly, so imagine if he was not thrown out of that particular train, so he would have been practicing as a lawyer. But he thought of what good lies within this particular situation of mine, and actually the good is he being insulted, and today he is been recognized throughout the world. Similarly, Kapil Sharma, you might be knowing, he used to sing in Jagratas, but people used to get bored, sometimes less audience used to be there. So he decided having a witty nature, he decided to be humorous, crack jokes in between, so that audience will be get stuck with him and he'll be more entertained. A great stand-up comedian today. So that habit or that blessing in this disguise has become his profession today. Your mind from why to what, your answers will be such that they will inspire you, and once they inspire you, you must follow it by your actions. And when you do action, your action should be consistent and persistent, and don't forget to follow the rule of five. The rule of five states that what action or what five actions step that I need to take every day, no matter what, to achieve my number one goal, and then start perseverance unless until you get succeeded in your goals.